at all risk of potentially designated damage between with the students. It's kind of simple role play. What I'm suggesting in a lot of the projects I see is the teacher goes into a role as well, then there are certain things that can happen with language that don't happen otherwise. So I want to spend a little bit more time on the next workshop I do, which will be in the autumn sometime next time I visit. Okay. So I'd be very interested in sort of setting up a scenario where we kind of, I take you through a drama, but give kind of opportunity to try out different skills and different approaches, think about how it's constructed, and give you opportunities to join in how it's structured. But that will be for next time. Today, this workshop this was my colleague now, Dr. Wang, who's a specialist in Chinese literature, so she's obviously, we proposed this project together, and that's the poem. I know it's extremely well known in China. It's something that children are expected to learn. So you can just learn it on by heart, rote, there you go. But in doing that, there's an awful lot that we can kind of miss out in terms of, it won't necessarily make us understand the poem, and it certainly won't necessarily make us enjoy or appreciate the poem. That's an English translation of it, which I need. Okay. So the idea, why bring these things together, particularly for a second language learner? Well, there's this idea of, obviously, if you're learning a second language is part of something bigger, which is a culture. And second language students, ethnic minority students living in Hong Kong, they will be, there'll be the culture of Hong Kong, of China, around them as they live. But they've got to feel part of this. Mastering the language is also part of entering the culture. And if you're living in a place, if you're going to become an insider in that particular place where you're living, somehow it's not the language is access to the culture, it's access to something bigger. And it's this idea of a lingua culture, which says two things come together. And they can be quite monolithic. If you're kind of outside that, it's very hard to get into it. And part of education is to help you become an insider in all kinds of subjects that we study. An insider in maths, an insider in history, you know it. Yeah. The issue that we have in England is how do you get students to become insiders to Shakespeare, access Shakespeare, feel that Shakespeare belongs to them and not just to kind of some kind of elite. So the idea of culture then is, culture is something we live every day, synchronic, it's part of our everyday life, but there's also a history to it. And our education should help us, that culture is where it is because of things that have happened in the past. And of course art, and in this case poetry, are part of that culture, and are part of what survives in that culture that is valued by that culture. So again, an education should help young people appreciate, understand, but also be able to become part of that culture because this is what's valued in it. So that's another aspect of a broad educational reason for helping students access something like literature in general, and in this case, the time of poem. But poetry and literature, we don't actually, if I can use Shakespeare as an example in my own country, it's one thing to be able to write an essay about Shakespeare and pass an exam. It's quite another thing to actually enjoy Shakespeare. And to someone like myself, it seems to me there's absolutely no point for me. There's no point in learning about art or poetry unless you enjoy it, unless you can learn to enjoy it. And part of the teacher's job is to say not only kind of know something, but actually appreciate it, have some connection with it. And that's really easier said than done. So how do you actually help students connect with with something, make something matter to them, feel that they kind of can get something out of it, relate to it in some way that isn't just I can talk about it or I can recite it, but there's something here that we can kind of feel about it at the same time. Poetry, as well, is a particular use of language, and in this particular, in the Chinese tradition, as I understand it, and I understand it from the poem, that the language of inference. Sometimes, as second language learners, and I taught French for a long time, what we concentrate on is the transactional aspect of the language. I say something, you understand what I mean, you react to it. And it's just that everyday transaction, very, very important. But of course, it's a more sophisticated use of language is to know what somebody's inferring when they use a language. It's kind of knowing what they mean by what they don't say. By as much as what they do say. You know. So for example, if I went up to somebody and said, do you like that shirt? So all I've said is, do you like that shirt? Oh. You're inferring all kinds of meanings from how I've said it. Okay. I actually do like it. I'm only messing. I'm too drama. Okay. Alright. So that's business. So to be a successful communicator, successful language learner, it's kind of understanding how to use inference and when we infer meaning, not just when we kind of state the obvious. Okay? And poetry works on that, in particular this poem. And then finally, it's this point about if you are to really understand the poem or understand the art, you really only understand it if you feel it in some way. So how do we, and this is the question of, this is the issue of beauty and language and beauty, poetry and beauty and art and beauty. Then it's only really beautiful for me if I can feel it in some sense. Which is again, I feel is part of my role as a teacher to try and get students to value and to feel the beauty of, say, for example, Shakespeare. So these are the purposes of doing something like this short print poem. Now, you'll see that in this drama that we do, in order to try and appreciate and get close, bring children close to the poem, I will do an awful lot of other things. And all these other things involve language. So what I'm suggesting is that something like this kind of poem can actually, in order to teach it well, and to try and arrive hopefully at these aims, these objectives here, there's lots of other things that we can do that that also can be used as part of your broader language. So it isn't just like, I will do this poem, right, that's it. Right? I'm saying, no, we can do the poem like this, but we can build another whole range of language learning around it. All right. So that's what we'll be doing in this. Now,